Okay, we're working on our chicken puppet. I've got the head together. I've got the beak on. I've got the comb on. I've got the fleece on the head. What we're going to do with the beak and with the comb, I'm going to cover them with latex. This is Monster Latex. The latex they use for making monster masks. Monster mash, right? And now you could cover the beak and the comb with fleece, red fleece and orange fleece, or whatever colors you chose. That could be done. I'm choosing to use the latex, a little contrast. Before I put the latex on, I'm going to mask off a little bit to try to protect my fleece from excess latex. So I just got good old-fashioned masking tape. Temptation, of course, is to do really big pieces, but sometimes smaller pieces help follow the contours better. So mask this off. There we go, it kind of covers that edge. And on the comb. Now with the latex, if I do spill a couple drops, once it dries, it's actually easy to get off of stuff. It's not a glue, it's not adhesive. So. So I've got my masking tape on. You see that? Yeah, this is good. Now, I have my latex in jars. Let me show you what we're dealing with. This is Monster Latex. If you go to puppetbuildingworld.com to our tools and resources page, there's a link. You can pick this up. I've covered entire puppet heads with it. It works great for that. Now this is acrylic paint. Okay, got some jack-o'-lantern orange acrylic paint. I got a little jar with my latex in it. Come on, paint. Start with a little bit, mix this up. Just mixes right in, it's great. So easy to do. I think I want just a little darker. So I'm just mixing that in with this stir stick. My girls eat a lot of popsicles, so I have a lot of popsicle sticks. There's that orange. Tell you what, I'm going to put in just a little bit of red. That just a little darker orange. Stir that up good. And get another stir stick. Make some red for the comb. Shake that a little bit. That paint's thick. Get off of that angle. Close those up. A little more red here in my orange. I like these little jars, or bullion cube jars. But the latex I don't use, I can cover up, keep it from drying out too soon. Not making a real big batch. Probably made more than I need here. Not a real big batch. Okay, it doesn't want to red up enough. Gonna need some more red paint there. A little darker there. I use these little foam brushes. They're really inexpensive. And you throw it out when you're done. And we're going with the red here. You just kind of... So I need to stir that a little more. Puppet stand ready here. I'll be putting this on the puppet stand to dry when I'm done. Just kind of dab it on there. Actually, I'm kind of rushing. Well, I should be dabbing. Just kind of dab. My little girls were doing this when they were just six, so it's not hard to do. Nothing, just kind of dabbing. That would do you. Amazing how red this has turned. Comes out so, looking so pink. Dry into a nice rubbery. Get that over here if you can see that. So that it's going to dry up really nice. It's going to look really good. Let that dry. Be putting on a second coat. Wait for that. We've got our orange here. New brush. Let's see where I put the red in it. Out of that mouth. There we go. So we've got half the beak done. Got to do the other half. And I said I will be putting on a second, third coats. Inside of the mouth there. If you don't have the little foam brushes, you can. And I have just used pieces of scrap foam to dip, and that's fine. actually pretty easy. I've got the comb covered with latex. I've got the beak covered with latex. I had thought about what I might do is I might put wire in that comb and stiffen that comb a little bit. I don't want too. I like it loose. I like it kind of floppy. Maybe on the next one I'll wire the comb. I like this one floppy. But it's my puppet. I can do it the way I want. It's your puppet. You do it the way you want. That's one of the nice things about puppeteering and building puppets is freedom of expression. And I really enjoy that. So there he's got his first coat of latex on him.